Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.2, Problem 7. This is Section 5.2, Problem 7. So it says Bill and Sue just got married. They want to have $20,000 2 years from now for a down payment on a house. How much do they have to save every month at 9% compounded monthly to accomplish their goal? So, let's start with the problem. First of all, what type of formula do we use? We use the sinking fund formula because we know what the goal is and we want to figure out how much we save on a regular basis to reach it. We want to get $20,000. So the sinking fund formula is P equals A over some brackets. And in the brackets we have 1 plus R over M to the M times T power minus 1 divided by R over M. And we start filling it in. So P equals, A is the amount at the end, the goal. So for this problem, $20,000. And under the $20,000, we have some brackets with a numerator and a denominator. And the numerator, 1 plus R over M, is 1 plus, the R is the rate as a decimal, and for this problem, it's 9%. So as a decimal, 9% is 0.09. And underneath the R is an M. M is the type of compounding, how many times you compound per year. We have monthly compounding in this problem. So for monthly compounding, M is 12, 12 months in the year. And that has an exponent of M times T. So the M is 12 for monthly compounding. And the T is 2 because the problem says in 2 years. You want to reach your goal in 2 years. They're going to save money for 2 years. And after the parentheses is a minus 1. You want to be careful not to forget that. And then in the denominator of my brackets, I have R over M again. So again, R, the rate as a decimal, is 0.09. And M, the number of times compounded per year, is 12 because we're compounding monthly. That's how the formula fills in, and now we start some of the computation. As usual, when you have parentheses in any type of math, you need to deal with the parentheses first. So as I do that, P equals, we have a fraction with 20,000 on top of the fraction. Under the 20,000 in the denominator, you have brackets that form yet another fraction. And in the top of the brackets, or numerator of the brackets, we have 1 plus 0.09 over 12. 0.09 over 12 has come up a few times before. It's 0.0075. And again, if you forget that, just use your calculator. 0.09 divided by 12 equals, and the calculator will tell you, it's 0.0075. And again, in the parentheses, I'm going to add a 1 to that 0.0075. which would make it 1.0075, that's in parentheses, the 1.0075 rather. And the exponent is 12 times 2. 12 times 2 is 24. And then after the parentheses, we have a minus 1. In the denominator of the brackets, that 0.09 over 12, which again I know is 0.0075. And as I like to point out, I have the same decimal in the numerator and denominator of the brackets, but in the numerator there's a 1 in front of the decimal, in the denominator there's none. So now what happens is I have to deal with that exponent of 24th power. So as I do that, I'm going to have P equals a fraction with 20,000 in the numerator of the fraction. And under the numerator, I have a bracket with yet another fraction. And I'm going to have some big number I get with 1.0075 to the 24th. There'll be a minus 1 after the result. And in the denominator of the brackets, a 0.0075 still. So for 1.0075 to the 24th power, definitely need a calculator for that. So I'll clear the screen off my calculator. I'll do 1.0075. Press the exponent button of the calculator. Put in 24 for the exponent. Hit equals. And the calculator tells me that the result of that big exponent, that 24th power, is 1.19641359. So at this stage of the formula, I have p equals 20,000 over some brackets, and the numerator of the brackets 1.19641135 29 minus 1, and in the denominator of the brackets 0.0075. So let me deal with that minus 1. That's very easy to do. So the next stage of the formula, I'm going to have p equals 20,000, and it's going to be over some brackets. In the top of the brackets, I'm going to have 0.19641135 29, and in the denominator of the brackets 0.0075. So now if I divide 0.19641135 29 divided by 0.0075, I'll get the value in the brackets down to one number, which isn't good. So that'll give me p equals 20,000 over some brackets with the number. Let me figure out what that's going to be. 20,000 over 26.1884709. So, to finish the problem off, I'm going to do 20,000 divided by 26.1884709. And again, the most straightforward way is just to clear the screen of the calculator and enter 20,000 divided by 26.1884709. That's on the screen of the calculator now. I hate to clear it and then re-enter it. So save it in memory first, I say, then do 20,000 divided by recall memory. And that gives me a final answer of 763.6948456. So I have like seven digits after my decimal point, which is way too much. I just want two places after the decimal point for how many cents. So after the decimal, I have 0.694 something, something, something. The four isn't big enough to make it 70 cents. It's going to get chopped off at 69 cents. So the final answer is $763.69. So, if Bill and Sue save $763.69 every month, in 2 years, they'll have the $20,000 they need for down payment on a new home.